Hi, I'm Guy from Scoop. Configurations of MikroTik devices can seem daunting to anybody just starting out. However, MikroTik commands a strong global market share precisely because of the granular control you can exercise. The tech community loves their creative approach to finding different ways of doing things. If you're new to MikroTik, we'll help you overcome these initial hurdles and welcome you into a world of networking possibilities. In this portion of the series, we'll focus on guest Wi-Fi network setup. The plan is to configure a guest Wi-Fi network and ensure guests are on their own subnet. We start with a MikroTik device that already has a basic router and Wi-Fi configured, similar to what we showed you in previous episodes. We'll just add to it. We're using our tried and trusted MikroTik HAP AX2 in the demo, and at the time of recording, we will log into the device via Winbox 4.0 Beta 17. Assuming that you've kept pace with our previous Back to Basics videos, we're ready to start. Let's briefly summarize the steps we'll follow. First, we'll create a new Wi-Fi interface and set client isolation. Second, we'll configure the IP for the guest network. Then, create a DHCP server for the guest network. Finally, we'll block guest access to the native network. Let's begin. Step 1. When logging into the device, navigate to Wi-Fi and create a new Wi-Fi interface. Configure the Wi-Fi as you would for an access point. We called ours 5GHz-guest. Depending on the frequency that you would like to use, select the corresponding Wi-Fi interface in the master option. We're using the 5GHz network in this example. For dual band, you'll do the same config with a new Wi-Fi interface, but set the master interface to the 2.4GHz Wi-Fi interface. Remember to configure the passphrase and authentication types for the Wi-Fi. Once done, go to Data Path and enable the Client Isolation option. This ensures that Wi-Fi devices connected to this network are unable to communicate directly with each other, which is typical in guest network scenarios. Step 2. Virtual interfaces in MikroTik can be treated exactly like physical interfaces, and now we can give the guest Wi-Fi an IP address. Go to IP, Addresses, and add a new one. We are using 192.168.99.1/24 and select the guest Wi-Fi as the interface. With this in place, we head to step 3, creating the DHCP server for the guest network. Navigate to IP, DHCP server. While in the DHCP tab, there's an option on the right called DHCP setup. Click this option. Select the guest Wi-Fi as the interface on which the DHCP server will run. Address space we leave on our guest LAN subnet. The gateway IP should match the guest Wi-Fi LAN IP by default. We can then define our range of addresses to handout, which we will leave as is, but this can be adjusted for smaller networks. The DNS server IPs should automatically pull from your DHCP or triple PoE client configuration. Alternatively, you can specify a DNS server of your liking. In the last step, we leave the lease time default, but again, can be adjusted to match your own use. Once everything is complete, the server will hand out IPs to devices connected to the guest Wi-Fi. It might state that the interface is not running, but this is because there is nothing connected to the guest Wi-Fi just yet. Once a device connects to it, the flag will go away and the DHCP server will be running. Final step. At this point, the guest will get an IP when connecting to the network. Since this is a guest network, we need to add a firewall rule to prevent unauthorized connectivity to our private LAN. This is achieved by creating a rule which blocks traffic originating from the guest network through the router to the LAN. Go to IP, Firewall, Filter Rules, and add a new one. Set the chain to forward, which targets traffic passing through the router. Set the in interface to match the guest network. Then set the out interface to bridge. Head to the action tab and configure the action as drop. Now all communication initiated from the guest network destined for the native network will be dropped. You can verify this by simply pinging across the network as a guest Wi-Fi user. In addition, client isolation will ensure that all guests are completely separated from each other. Thank you so much for watching. Please remember to give the video a like and subscribe. We'll be looking further at firewalls, queues, and more in future videos. See you there.